in here that the idea of courts are not part of the Great Reset. The idea that you'll come and get justice, that justice will be dispensed under the one world government, it's a joke. We're here to try and save these courts. We believe in the rule of law. We believe in this book. We believe that judges can be fair and on the side of justice, and that barristers and solicitors go in to that trade in order to dispense justice to the people fairly, and that they remember their very, very significant role. Their job is to protect the freedom of the people, a people who fought harder than any other people, probably in the world, for freedom. Our name, the Irish, is synonymous with freedom. So it won't be for lack of anything we didn't do. It will be their decision. It will be their decision. And if they decide to close down their own courts, do themselves out of a job, that's their choice. We are moving away now from the state. We've tried everything to make the state correct itself, to stop behaving as a dictatorship, as a tyrannical force. But it looks like that is not going to happen. So there is going to be a divide of those of us who say, we do not recognise you. You are corrupt from top to bottom. Your police force, your health service, your schools, your courts. So you no longer exist to us. We will no longer pay for our destruction, for the destruction of our Irish economy. We will no longer fund the criminality. This day is coming, and we who walk away from it, we will survive it. Yes. We will survive it. Yes. These people in their yellow vests, as I spoke about 2 years ago, they're bringing about their own demise. When I was dragged into a squad car a couple of years ago, I said to them as they were bringing me to throw me into a cell, you will have no pensions. If you continue down this road, you will have no jobs. And they laughed in my face. But it's the truth. All of their days are numbered because robots and AI are going to be doing their jobs. It's over. Democracy is finished. The West is going to fall into the most tyrannical rule. Even the Chinese, Stalin would blush. So we have won already. The victory is ours because truth is on our side, justice is on our side, morality is on our side. So all of those words equal God. Yes. Yes. And we never forget the opening preamble that all of our rights come from the Holy Trinity. And they cannot be taken by any man in there. They can play their games. They've brought us round in you know, circles of word salad today in there. And it is their decision. But we do not come begging for our God-given rights. We are only coming to see, does the Constitution still stand in the courts? It will always stand with us. It will always stand with us. It will not be taken from us. Thank you again.
Two thoughts at this stage that I want to just kind of, qualify and moderate what I said earlier. The first thing is we were warned by the Chief Justice in advance twice at the hearing, the initial, hearing a couple of weeks ago, and this morning, that you know, we would be asked questions, and we expected that. And, you know, not to take it too personally, you know, it's kind of hard to take too when you can't actually get to your own points for being interrupted from the bench constantly. I mean, I had notes written out. I got about halfway through what I had prepared because I kept being interrupted by the judges. And so maybe that's the par for the course. I mean, a lawyer would say, well, that there means the breaks. But my feeling is that, I have to say, there is a sense that it's not going to go our way. That's my feeling. I don't like to tempt fate, but I'll tell you what it is. Overall of that, I was working on an article recently in relation to hypnosis about the whole concept, which I haven't published yet, it's going up maybe in a few days, called the creation in a situation like this of a pseudo-reality.